many of you all must be familiar with House MD. So further, physical particulars of this drug will be explained through reference from House MD episode by Gina Shah. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. Vismaya, switch on your audio, please. As the whole concept of this seminar is that we take away the remedy and we remember it as it is, so my batch has come up with the idea of explaining it through the videos. We will observe the video and then see what points are similar in the drug and similar to the patient. The video is about an autistic child who has worms. Let's see. Next slide.
More juice?
Much more juice. He has to ask for it. Adam? Buddy, eyes here.
He's tired, Dom.
Wouldn't be if we stuck to the schedule. Show me the juice, buddy.
I think we first have to ask
him. He has to ask for it. Adam!
He's choking.
It's impossible. Mac and cheese.
So we saw that the child was asking for juice. That tells us about the intense thirst which is seen in the drug. The thirst is intense for ice cold water, which is swallowed greedily. There is deficient appetite. There is a case mentioned in Clark. At the end of the video, we could see that the child was choking. The case is one night he choked after eating a teaspoonful of nourishment, threw up blood and pus and died without struggle. In the episode, the child doesn't die because he goes to a good doctor. Like I said, that the case is about an autistic child, which tells us about the mentals, which is irresolution, want of confidence, unfitting him for work of any kind. Next slide.
No obstructions, nothing. Which means the only symptom was a scream, which is diagnostic of nothing.
He clutched his chest, BP was elevated, maybe there was chest pain.
The nurse said the heart was fine.
Don't be so quick to dismiss me.
So here we could see that they check for any mechanical obstruction. In the remedy, we see that the obstruction is because enlargement of the glands of neck, parotid and submaxillary. They swell up in 5 days and continue to increase till the throat was so filled as nearly to prevent swallowing. We also see that the BP was elevated. In the remedy, it is mentioned that the pulse is quick and full, which is a symptom of hypertension. In the remedy, the right pulse is soft and steady, whereas left one is absent. Similarly, the swelling is more in the left parotid than the right one, which tells that the remedy has left-sided affinity. Next slide.
You might not have 10 minutes.
I don't have 10 minutes.
No, you don't.
Next slide. So like we know that autistic child really do not like to be engaged. So they're irritable and restless and wants everything satisfied with nothing, which we've already discussed. We can also see that in the video. Next slide. When the doctor comes to check upon the child, we see that he starts vomiting. The symptom seen in the drug is that vomiting with purging and severe abdominal pain. Like we know, it is a worm remedy, so the pain is obvious. The vomiting is yellowish and slimy, just as seen in the video. The vomiting is from 11 p.m. till next forenoon with frequent eructations. Next slide. Please observe the face of the child. Play. So here we can see that there is paleness around the mouth, whereas there is redness around the cheeks. You can also see that the size of the lips is larger than ones which were previously seen. Next slide. So from this we can remember the face of the child, which is red hot face. Staring eyes is not seen since the child is autistic. The face is pale around the mouth. One cheek red, the other white, which is also seen in Cinna. There is convulsive movements of muscles of face, especially lips and lids. And the lips are swollen to enormous size, glistening with distension. Next slide.
Bells, screaming.
What'd you find in the stool sample?
You were too busy bothering Cuddy. As discussed, it was negative for parasites. Can we get out of here?
I didn't ask what you didn't find. I asked what you did find in the stool sample.
Stool? And traces of iron, zinc, calcium carbonate. Can we leave?
What's the matter? You afraid of the man? Uh-oh. Too late.
Feed my...
Guggenheim in 15 minutes. Like that.
I'm going to count to three, and then I'm going to fire you. One.
Calcium carbonate, that's anti-diarrheal, right?
Two. I
think that's significant.
So here we can see that in the stool it was negative for parasites, but they did have large quantity of calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate cause in the stool could be two things. One is spica, and second is that if the patient has been taking antidiarrheal in large quantities. Since he was taking antidiarrheal in large quantities, that means that he suffered from diarrhea. The symptoms of diarrhea in the drug are purging of watery, flaky, foul-smelling stools, followed by vomiting in a few hours. Stools are copious, grayish, putrid smelling, and there is well-marked tenesmus. Pica could also be present. Next slide.
Game over. You'll be dead.
What the hell are you doing?
Show me what you ate. Adam, show me what you ate. Adam?
Honey? Adam?
So here, if you have seen, next slide, that the vision through the child's eye was different than the vision through the audience perspective, that tells us that there is some defect in the eye. The first observation was that there were blue rings around the eyes. There is hallucination of vision, which is seen in the remedy. Objects seem to totter and dance. Vision of figures, cherries, animals, etc. There is flickering before eyes, photophobia and lacrimation. Eyes rolled convulsively, pressure in eyes, pupils enormously dilated. The remedy also has symptom of vertigo, where every object looks bright green in color, and head turning and twisting, restlessness with intense headache. The eye symptoms of the drug are the most important symptoms. Next slide.
Seeing them all the time.
What are you looking for?
He's telling us what he was seeing. Telling us exactly what was wrong with him. Drawing it for us over and over again. Nobody knew how to speak autistic. When I asked him what he ate, he even told me that.
What are you talking about? What was he seeing?
Hello, my... It is. It's not a tumor forming. It's worms swimming in his eye.
Animal makes potty in the sandbox. Boy plays in the sandbox. Boy eats the sand. You can probably tell where this is going by now.
Stool samples were negative for parasites.
Raccoon roundworms are not excreted by their human host.
Cameron tested the sand.
All of it. Worms spread from his gut to the rest of his body.
Next slide. So like we know that there is worms in his eyes, they were not excreted because raccoon worms are not excreted through the human host. This tells us about the diagnosis of worm infestation. The complete pathophysiology will be explained by Nehal. But another symptom of worms is that there is cough incessant all night from tickling in larynx and trachea. Next slide. Here I want you to observe the limbs of the child.
Act.
listen. Thanks.
You saved his life.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
Next slide. Yeah, so you could observe that there was spasm of limbs, twitching of hands and feet, convulsive jerking of upper limbs. The gait was also unsteady, tottering and staggered, just like seen in the drug. In the drug, there is actual convulsions, which were not seen in the patient, but we could correlate. So this is an attempt to explain the particulars through the video method. Further pathophysiology will be continued by Nehal. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Nehal Shah.